So hello, welcome back everyone to our Chih Chat with Jessica here at the Cancer Support Community. And once again, we have live people in the room, so excited. And happy almost Thanksgiving. Wow, this is, you know, the time of year when, if no other time of year, we should truly get in touch with our blessings. There are so many people right here and on the margins of our little universes that are in such dire straits. And maybe we don't feel empowered to affect any of that. But what we can do is take really good care of ourselves. It's kind of like the old put the oxygen mask on yourself first rule, you know? So how about today we dedicate our practice to doing as what the venerable Thich Nhat Hanh, Lao Tzu, and Justin Stone sages used to say, let's walk as if our feet are kissing the earth, and perhaps then we'll realize that wherever we happen to be standing is the land of the lotus. I think that would be a great way to start. So we will leave no trace as we move from one foot touching the ground into the other and then back again, the way all indigenous elders and wise people live their lives. Let's all do that as well. And again, I'm Jessica Lewis. I'm the founder of a small company called Sculpt Your Life. You can find me, just Google it. That's the easiest way to go. And the three modalities that I teach actually are how to move well, how to eat well, and how to relax well. And how to relax well, the third leg of the stool, is why we're here week after week. Because frankly, it's been my experience that you can move really well, you can eat really well, but if you're stressed out, at some point your health is going to give away. So today we're going to go over a particular style of Tai Chi called Tai Chi Cha. That third word is pronounced cha. And if you translate that phrase from Chinese into English, what you get is knowledge of the supreme ultimate. You can tell right there why this particular style of Tai Chi has been qualified by some of our most well-respected medical communities in the Western world as nothing other than mindfulness in motion. No martial application here whatsoever. So, when we do touch each other, we're basically going to be doing mindfulness while we're moving. Double prizes, because a lot of people love the idea of doing mindfulness, but they just can't sit still long enough to do it. So let's get started. All right, so since I have live folks in the room that are very mobile and very capable, we're going to do the practice standing. One thing I really want everybody to know every single time I teach is there's no such thing as bad Tai Chi Cha. And what that really means is the best way to do it is with the effort of no effort at all, if you can manage that. So even the effort of wondering, am I moving my hands correctly, that is too much work. Just know that everything you're doing is awesome as long as you just copy what you see to the best of your ability and tell yourself, oh, here I am doing Tai Chi Cha. That's awesome. That's going to be great. Okay? All right. And the only other thing I want to tell you is one of the reasons why this practice is generally considered so much fun and easy to learn and adaptive is because in between each one of the movements, we come to a moment in which we are simply just emotionless on the outside. There's always lots of stuff flowing around the inside, but on the outside, we flow from and then back to like just a quiet stance, right? So let's all figure out how to do that right now. And then what we'll do is we'll spend a few moments just really focusing on whatever might be happening in the inner landscape, and then we'll go right into our practice. So if my feet were my hands, and I could pick them up and show them to you really easily, you'd see that they're sort of going to be, yep. Yep, so whatever V feels comfortable to you is fine. Just if it's good, if it feels good, let your heels be a little bit closer to your toes. Let's all do that. I'm going to fish around and find the spot that feels really good to me. I think here it is. All right, so now you're looking at me from the side, so you can probably see. This is the way I stand under normal conditions. It's not during Tai Chi Chuan practice. I stand like this. I'm not really sure if I'm sticking my butt out or my chest out or a little bit of both, but most of the time when I'm just sort of hanging around, not doing Tai Chi Chuan, my knees are usually sort of straightened and in the back. And when I'm standing like this, mostly I feel my weight in my heels. Do you feel the same? Yes. Yes, there's Charlotte agrees. All right, so let's do this. Let's pretend our favoriteest little person in the whole world comes up behind us and just tickles us on the back of the knees, and it's a nice little reminder, just soften up. Just let the knees be soft, all right? And when you do that, do you also feel your tailbone kind of naturally tucked? Yes. Charlotte's is naturally tucking under there. Now here's the really magical thing though. Does your weight also just suddenly magically spread out across the soles of both your feet? Do you feel? Yes. This is a lovely floor here. It's caramel color. So let's pretend the floor is actually not hardwood. Let's pretend it's made of caramel and it's gooey. So let's just feel the entire lower body, or at least your feet, just sinking down into the gooey floor a little bit. Let's just feel that with every little millimeter of both our feet. Feel your feet really one with the earth right now. And now we need to figure out what to do with the hands. We want our hands to have a natural resting spot too. So if we were sitting, enjoying the practice from that position, our hands would be resting on our thighs. So all we do is just let the arms hang down. Yeah, you can even wiggle them out, let the yagas out. And then just lift the fingers. Yeah. And the palms will sort of naturally end up being about the level of where your hip hinges, you know, where the crease in your hip is. Or where your thighs would be if you were sitting. So just feel your hands resting on something firm and horizontal, like a pocket of energy. Right? Here we are just resting. This is going to be the position we flow from and back to in between each one of the movements. And while we're in this position, I'm going to get my singing bowl. Let's each of us pick a little spot somewhere in our inner landscapes, anywhere from the belly button down, to focus our attention on. People always ask me, why do you have me to think about my belly button or what's below? Well, I don't know. Energy follows thought, and if you're thinking about something down there, you're probably getting your head out of your head a little bit. It's a ninja mind trick. That's all working. So pick a spot. And we're going to really dial in our attention now while I call the bell. Here we go. Just noticing the spot of our choice. With our attention, our mind's eye, our awareness. Just notice all the little thoughts and sensations associated with that spot. out to the side a little bit with our left leg. By the way, if you get your left and right confused, so that also doesn't matter all that much. We're going to Tai Chi Chuan police. So I don't know. To me, it seems like the easiest way to do that is to just sort of sink a little bit into the right leg, and the left leg will almost move out there by itself. And we're going to straighten out the toes. And now we want to let the weight glide as easily to the rear of us as we can. So, to my way of thinking, just lengthening your knees kind of already puts it in your heels. And then just put the hands back there. You really feel it back there now? Yeah. Good. And we're just going to, I'm going to step horizontal, hip on the side. We're just going to let the weight glide all the way to the front of the feet and all the way back. And I use the word glide here, but I could use the word slide. Because although if you do this movement long enough, or maybe not even very long at all, you'll start to feel almost as if you're sitting in a rocking chair. But I want you to move with the effort of no effort at all. So how about this? Why don't we all just think about how easily we'd be able to move forward and back if we were sitting on a glider on the front porch. You know, you almost just have to look at that thing and it'll start to move. Yeah. That's about the easiest style of forward and back movement I can possibly think of, is sitting on a front porch glider. I wish I could see Charlotte. She's really flowing. Flowing. That's a good word to apply here. When we do Tai Chi Chuan, some of the ways to create that effort of no effort thing is to just move softly and slowly, almost like you're flowing from the center out. And continuously, or you could say circularly. And of course, these are the ways the body moves when you're just ready to relax. And it's one reason why this qualifies as mindfulness practice, because when we move this way consciously, or this is just my opinion, I'm about to say, it's like the body can't help but relax. We're tricking the body into being relaxed by letting it move the way it does when it's already relaxed. Let's do a few more. Here on the face sheet. And when I face you, I generally mirror. When I turn sideways, I generally don't. Let's do two more. Here's one. And on the last one, we want to head back the direction we came. So we're just going to glide a little forward and a little bit to the side. And just laying back in that nice soft rest position. That's great. That's really great. Just feel your body not moving for a moment. Just notice what that feels like. Feel your feet touching the ground. And let your thoughts be where your feet are, right? You'll be right in the present moment when you do that. Let's do bird flaps and swings. So we're going to put the hands really close together, about halfway between the belly button and the groin. And now all we're going to do is let the weight just glide or slide into the front of the feet. So you're going to feel yourself kind of dropping as you drift forward. Yeah. And the knees will expand. And the hands just sort of flip out there like little bird wings. Now we're going to draw a little circle while our hands are out there. Here it comes. Yeah. And then right there. So that's one set of three moves. We're going to do two more sets like that. Here we go. So So just sink, glide, and float. Sink, glide, and flip. Yeah. And here's a circle at the end of the flip. I always tell people this is the only time you can flip some of the bird and it's not a weird gesture. Just gonna flow back down to your restroom. Feel your body not moving. Really feel your feet touching the ground. Wherever you happen to be is the land of the lotus. Let's do around the platter. So how are we going to get one leg further out from the other? It's really, 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 really easy if you do it the following way. So here we go, we're going to sink down a little lower. You might feel your tailbone tucking under a little bit more. And then we're going to let as much weight as humanly possible flow into the right leg. Here we go. And when you're really, really rooted in that right leg, the left leg should feel so empty that you can just extend the knee and the little empty heel will just drop down wherever it wants to go. That's perfect. And just imagine that you have like a big round platter out in front of your heart and you're going to put your hands in the back. And then you're going to let all the weight flow from this leg into the sky and it's going to push the hands forward. Out, over whichever really happens to be out there. Yeah. And back. Move the leg in the back. Yeah. We're definitely flowing from the center here. In terms of the hands, you feel your belly kind of expanding maybe as you flow forward and contract as you flow back. And let that be responsible for pushing the hands out there and pulling them back. Yeah. See if you can let your upper body just sort of ride forward and back. On the weight shift, your entire lower body is caving. Nice. Very nice. Let's do one more. And when we're really back in the back leg, just stand up on it. Yeah. You should see Shara, she's great. And I'm going to the other side while facing it. I'm going to mirror you now. So here we go. We're going to sink down a little lower and we're going to shift all the weight into your left leg now. And let your empty, hopefully, right leg extend there. And here are your hands at the back of the platter. Good. Here we go. Out. Over the leg that's out there. Towards the leg in the back. Nice. Let's go even slower. We're leaving no trace. Like the smokeless runners of the Serengeti. They leave no dust when they run across the plain. It's like we're walking in slow-mo and then changing our minds. One more. And we're really in the back again. Yeah, just rest a moment. Take a moment to let your thoughts be where your feet are. Not in the past, not in whatever future may or may not happen. Right here. Let's do a round the platter variation. So I'll mirror you again. We're going to sink down. We're going to shift all the way into your right leg now. Yeah. It starts exactly the same as around the platter, only with a tiny little change. Let's do only six of these now. We'll see if we can fit the whole practice in. So we'll call this six. And we're all the way in the back again. Just rest back there. Feel your body resting for a moment. Let's do the other side. Here we go. Sinking and shifting. And extending the empty leg. Good. And here's the little variation. It's on. It's like we suddenly have a ball between our hands and then it just sort of falls off the front of the platter. Nice. This is only her second session. She looks like a pro. You should see her.
Just give it to you.
Now, it's true that she has some experience with Tai Chi. Let's do this one last one. And then flow back to the soles of the feet. But I know a ton of really awesome Tai Chi instructors because of this federal Tai Chi for Veterans program that I teach. And they all swear that Tai Chi Cha is the easiest thing they've ever learned. Were you experiencing that? Is it easier? Yeah. So that's got to mean it's more fun, right? Easier is always more fun. Right. Okay, let's do bass drum. Here we go. We're going to sink down. We're going to shift into your right leg so your empty left leg can extend. And the hands are going to come up to about chest height, about shoulder width apart. Yeah, and here we go. As you flow forward. Yeah. Here, I'll turn sideways, you can see. It's like your fingertips are just sort of trailing around that really smooth metal lip. The outside edge of a high school marching band bass drum. Can you just visualize that? Let's do one more. And then just stand up. Sink, very nice. Let's do the other side. Here we go. We're walking as if our feet are kissing the earth. Because that's the way we should always walk. I love Thanksgiving. It should really be renamed Unity Day. It's like one of those rare moments in American history in which we realize if we don't join together with Earth and Indigenous peoples, we're going to die. Let's do two more. And float back to rest. Feel your body. Externally doing nothing for a moment, but in touch with the earth. Let's do dog on the mountaintop. Here we go. We're going to sink down, shift all the way into your right leg again. Let your empty left leg extend. Just turn the palms over. And as you flow forward, the hands come up like you're going to clap, but then they miss each other and they just fall. Yeah. Very nice. And let me see the palm of your hand when they cross and then fall. Rather than the tips of your fingers. That would be more like cross swords, right? Good. Let's do two more. Last one. Back to the soles of the feet. Most Tai Chi practices have, we're sinking down, some version of that move into your left leg. Yes. But all the others are more about disarming your opponent of their weapon. So this is much different from that. You can tell this is moving meditation, not a martial art. You've got these very open and receptive palms at all times during this good. During all of it, really. Let's do one more. Float down to your hands. And let's do Daughter of the Valley, which is a very complementary move to the one we just did. We're going to glide into the right leg and let the left leg extend, and the hands are going to come up to about chest height again, only facing out. And as we glide forward, the hands come together and rise. And as we glide back, they come back to where we started. Yeah. It's almost like you're bringing a cup up to your lips. Side of facing you, I'll mirror you. So we're going to sink down and into your left leg this time. Let your empty right leg extend. Yep, here are the hands. And here we go. Yeah. When you glide forward, see if you feel your belly expanding. And then when you glide out, feel it contracting. It's like it's sending the hands up out of its way. And pulling them back down. Good. Nice. One more. And rest. Very nice. It's just like all the other Tai Chi practices, like during each one of these movements, at least one or two body parts is drawing circles in the air. That's what we were really doing just now. And now we're going to do carry the ball to the side, which is a side-to-side move, and you're going to see a nice big circle in the air rather than the hands separated. You'll have them together the whole time. It's super easy. I'll modify a little bit so I don't step out of the line of sight of the camera. So let's all sink down and let's glide as much as you can into the right leg, and then we're going to let the whole upper body actually rotate a little bit to your right. Yeah. And you're going to know if that happened because your shoulders and your hips are both going to kind of rotate. So just put the hand up on the side of the body where the shoulders and the back. Yeah. And put the other hand in front of it. Yeah. Same ball that we had when we were doing around the body variation. And now the empty leg is almost just going to slide away to the side, heel first. Good. And that way your feet will be pretty much in the same position they were a minute ago, only farther apart. And you won't likely step out farther than you can if you go heel first. And here we go. We're just going to let all the weight flow into what was the empty leg. And then back into the original leg, which was empty before and now it's not. Yeah. Nice. On the third one, wait till this leg is all the way filled and then just stand up on it and rest. That was great. Now, normally we would do that same thing three more times, but you won't see me by then. I'll be out the door. So we're just going to go back the way we came. Here we go. We're sinking. We're going to shift and we're going to rotate and then the hands are going to go up. Yeah. And the empty heel is going to just sort of glide away to the side. And back we go. The same circle we were drawing a minute ago in the air, during Jolly in the Valley, only now the hands are together. And then just stand up. Yes! And sink down. Even though she didn't feel like she knew what she was doing, she did great. I'm telling you, it's the effort of no effort. It's really key here, right? Just do what you see. It's all going to be good. Let's do two more sets just like that. So we're going to sink. We're going to shift, we're going to rotate, place the hands and the heel, and then glide. And it's not even like gliding and arriving, we just keep gliding and change directions. Now on the third one, we're going to float up and float down. Yeah, and let's go back again. Sink, shift, rotate, hands, heel, flow. Nice. Float up, float down. Yeah, just so you get a really good muscle memory for the side to side moves, we're going to do one more set. Sink, shift, rotate, hands, heel, glide. Nice. Float up, float down. Kiss the earth down there, and let's do it again. Look, I mushed all of that together instead of breaking it down into pieces and trying to stuff all along just fine. It's easy stuff here. Ain't rocket science. Float up. Float down. Just take a moment to feel your body not moving on the outside. And we know from physics, there's so much stuff flowing around in there, even when we're not moving on the outside. Just feel your body resting. Let's do push-pull. Okay. We're going to put this foot out first. It's probably your left. So let's sink down and shift all the way this way. And then the empty leg can extend all by itself. Yeah, here we go. As we flow forward, the hands flow forward. As we flow back, the hands flow back. Yes. Flowing from the center. I didn't tell you before that one reason why you feel your belly expanding, contracting when you're flowing forward and back is because we have this amazing energetic heart down there. The Chinese call it the Dong Qian. Let's do one more. And flow back to rest. But this shouldn't come as a surprise to you, because every ancient culture acknowledges that we have an energetic heart in our guts that's way smarter than our brain and way braver than our heart. And when we flow from the gut and let the whole body just follow along, we're really moving in a much more natural and totally integrative manner. So let's do the other side, flowing from the center out, okay? Here we go, we're gonna sink down, we're gonna shift all the way to your left leg, let your right leg extend, and the hands come up here, let your Dong Qian expand as you flow forward, and contract as you flow out, yes! Because every darn thing in the whole universe is in constant flux, between expansion and contraction. So why not get in touch with how the human body can move that way too? Nice. Let's do one more. And rest. two left leg can flow forward. And it's as if our hands are under the same plate we had out there before. When we're doing around the platter, here we go. Yes. Exactly. Physics a minute ago, we also know from physics that utilizing a Tai Chi practice in which there are moments of movement and moments of motionlessness, let's do one more and we'll come to rest. And rest. Is actually in perfect accordance with physics. Because the truth is, water and time and air and all of the greatest, most powerful things in the universe move in ways in which they speed up and slow down all the time, depending on what is passing through them or what they're flowing around. The stream will speed up or slow down. It's all part of laminar flow, which is sometimes a little faster, sometimes a little slower. So right now we're just building up our strength in order to move forward. Let's sink down, shift into your left leg, let your empty right leg extend, and then we fly forward. You know, when the water runs around a rock, around the backside of a rock in the stream, it just sort of eddies there. It gathers its energy, and then it just sort of bursts out. That's all we're doing. Flow back down to rest. Feel your body resting. Let's pull some taffy. Easy, easy, easy stuff. Here we are resting. We're going to sink. We're going to shift to your right. We're going to rotate the upper body. And now notice which shoulder came out in front. It's probably your left. So just place that arm like that. Yeah. Put the other hand on top. Let your empty heel glide out to the side. Good. As you flow that way, the hands will separate. Yeah. And just stand up. Good. We're pulling sticky, gooey, soft, silky energy between our palms when we behave that way. Let's go back the other way. We're going to sink and shift and rotate. And place the underhand and the other on top and the heel. Yes. Pulling the taffy. We're rounding here a little bit. And then we're flowing back down to rest. Nice. Let's do that again. That was great. She's great. Sink, shift, rotate. Always orient the underhand. Yep. She's got it. Anyways, it's such a tiny move compared to some of the bigger Tai Chi moves, right? Parting the wild horse's mane is probably what looks the most similar to this, but that's a really big move. Nice. And rest. Let's just feel our bodies resting for a minute. I'm going to try to whiz through the other variations quickly. So I'll tell you what, let's begin as if we were going to pull regular taffy. We're sinking, we're shifting, we're rotating. Now the empty heel, instead of going to the side, is going to go forward. And since our bellies are turned, so is that front toe. We're going to glide forward first and turn around and come right back. Now we're doing the first variation. This one's called anchor taffy. And now we're going to sink, shift, rotate, empty heel to the side, and pull taffy to the side. This move is just like the first one, only it's got extra parts. It's like the cha-cha. There's a forward, back, and then a side-side thing. So here we go. Sink, shift, rotate. Yeah. Empty heel, forward. Glide forward and reverse. You should see Charlotte. She's really great. Sink, shift, rotate. Yeah. I wish all my students were as open and accepting as she is. She's just copying what she sees, and it's working just fine. Let's do one more set like that with me. Here we go. Let's do one more, going forward first. Look at what an open and receptive gesture this is. In other styles of Tai Chi, we'd be sticking each other with swords or bows or something. But here we have this open hand, which is the universal way that people greet each other, at least they did in the ancient world, to show they have no weapon, with an open palm. Nice. And rest. Just feel your body rest. Let's do the second variation. Many people call this just wrist circles tappy. I'm turning sideways so you can see how this is basically just allowing the weight to shift into the heels and then allowing it to shift into the balls of the feet while the fingertips just draw a little circle in the air. So here we are. We're going to do a couple of wrist circles with that shifting back and shifting forward thing. Here we go. We're shifting back. We're shifting forward. Yeah. It's almost like we're getting ready to ski. You know how you sort of shift to the front of your feet when you're going to ski? And then you're suddenly sort of tilted downhill a little bit. Have you ever done that? Or ice skating. That's how you get yourself going forward. You shift the balls of the feet. This is easy, right? Yeah. She's nodding. Good. Let's keep going. We're going to do two more just like that. One, two. Now this time, just let the fingers rise, and then we're just going to flow over towards your right, and we're going to pull taffy to the left. Easy. Nice. And rest. Let's do just two sets of wrist circles now. Just shift to the rear. Shift to the balls of the feet again. Now this time, when you shift to the rear, let the fingertips rise and then go ahead and put the taffy together and pull it apart. Nice. And rest. Let's do one more set of wrist circles taffy, and then we'll try to move on to something a little bit more complex. Flow over towards your right, yeah. Pull taffy to your left. And back to center. Again. Yes. Do a little bit of perpetual motion tapping. This is the last variation of pulling tapping. We'll do it one-handed first. And really, so easy. You know when you were kids, when you were bored, you would do this. Right? That's really all we're going to be doing here. Just letting the upper body rotate and it kind of just swings the arms across, right? Yeah, that's all we're going to be doing. Okay, so here we are resting. Actually, you can just let the arms hang down here. You're going to know which arm goes like this. because when the upper body rotates, whichever shoulder's out in front, that's going to be an arm that goes like this. So here we are, we're going to sink, and we're going to shift, and we're going to rotate, and there goes your left arm, yeah? Let your empty heel just sink out to the side, and as you begin to shift that way, here comes the other shoulder out in front. Yeah, and the only difference here is we're going to allow the upper body to rotate ever so much more slightly. So we'll actually peel the trailing heel off the floor for just a millisecond. And then you just put it right back down again. Yeah, she's got it, by George. It's not hard. My teacher April always says, if you think about Tai Chi Sha, you can pretty much think at it. So just don't think, just copy what you see. Good. I'll tell you what, we're going to come to rest when we move back this way. Let's just rest a little bit. And let's start again. We'll try with two hands. If you get confused, you have two options, either which is fine. You can stay confused, but that probably won't help. But it's okay, right? Or you can just enjoy the ride, and that will probably help a lot. So it's all good. There's no such thing as not Tai Chi Sha. Let's just do it. All right. So here we go. We're going to sink and shift. We're going to set it up as if we normally would do Regular Taffy. And then out goes the empty heel. And when we get to just about the middle, the hands basically just switch places. So by the time you're all the way at the other end, they're in the opposite spots, right? Yes, she's doing great. And see, you can let the upper body rotate just the tiniest bit more, and it'll peel your trailing heel off the ground. We'll just levitate for a sec, or a half a sec. She was great. This generates so much energy between the hands that are moving this way. Again, I know a lot of really awesome Tai Chi instructors, and they all say that they often feel, a lot more energy between their hands when they're doing some of the Tai Chi jumps like this than in any other style of Tai Chi. So how would we make this last one? The last one. And just like this. All right. I'm going to play with the order a little bit because I don't think we're going to get through the whole practice. Why don't we jump all the way down here to passing clouds? Because it's exactly like carry the ball to the side, only instead of the hands together, the hands are going to be independent. But in many ways, it's that same continuous motion that we just did that Charlotte did so beautifully, so I'm just going to take this. All right, so here we go. We're just feeling the body resting. We're going to sink down. We're going to shift to the left this time, and we're going to let the upper body rotate, and that's going to send a signal to the left hand to rise. It's like we're high-fiving in the door. And then let your empty right heel just sort of sneak out to the side. Good. And as we shift that direction, it's going to pull the left hand. And as we shift back, the right hand is going to be pulled in. Now, although this is as continuous as the last move, we don't allow the body, the upper body, to rotate quite as much as it did in the other move. So the feet are just going to stay glued down to the ground. You might feel one of them empty out and the other one fill up, but you're not going to feel that trailing heel want to actually peel itself off the floor. She looks great. How about we do one more set? To rest any way to Did you feel that moment in which both hands were kind of moving at the same time, one above and one below, and then they just switched? Did you feel that moment? So let's do working the pulley, because that's got that same one hand is above and the other is below, and then they switch kind of feel to it. Okay, and we'll probably call it a day, everybody. So let's sink down. Let's shift all the way into the right foot now, and let your empty left leg just extend to the front, and then the left hand is going to come up. Yeah. So whichever leg is out there, the hand goes up to the shoulder, and the other hand just turns over. So the hand on top is always moving forward from the shoulder, and the hand on the bottom is always going to be moving kind of level around the level of your elbow. And you probably already figured out we're going to let all the weight from the back leg flow into the front, but there's an upper body rotation in this one too. So here we go. As we flow forward, let the upper body kind of rotate away from the hand that's moving forward. Away from the hand that's moving forward, yes. And that's going to enable the retreating elbow to get behind you without any effort. You see her, she looks great. I'm serious. There's no such thing as bad Tai Chi Chuan, but she's doing ripping solid, good Tai Chi Chuan. That's really good. She does not look like a newbie. And again, I know an awful lot of Tai Chi instructors who would all say, this looks an awful lot like Repulse Monkey, but it's a lot smoother. And many people say it's more powerful. We're going to do one more. And as the body begins to shift backwards, we're just going to sort of float back down to rest as easily as you can. Feel your body resting for a moment. And let's sink and shift into the other side. Exactly. We're walking without leaving any trace. Almost as if your feet are kissing the earth. Because wherever you stand is sacred ground. That's why all people are valuable. And tomorrow, while you're having your Thanksgiving dinners, try to let your thoughts dwell on how much we all have in common. It's a hell of a lot more than what we don't. Let's do one more. And it's hard to have anything but compassion for people who are just like you, right? I'll tell you what, while we're in this position, let's simply end our practice today by having a few more moments of mindfulness, okay? So feel your feet in full contact with the ground. Feel your palms resting on something firm and horizontal. You can even imagine a little pillow of energy there. See if you can let your thoughts dwell on something anywhere from the belly button down on. While we call the bell, as Thich Nhat Hanh was often fond of saying. Here we go. attention, flow back to the room. So tomorrow, and maybe every day forward, why don't we hold the entire earth, no exceptions, in healthy, peaceful intention. And focus on all the gifts that we have, those we've asked for, and especially those we did not ask for. Amen. I hope you all have a really warm, loving, wonderful, blessed holiday season. Again, I'm Jessica Lewis. Company is Sculpt Your Life. Just Google me. You'll find me very easily. We're here at Cancer Support Community a couple times a month. We're hoping someday soon to go once a week, but right now we're just twice a month. Typically the second and fourth Wednesdays of every month at noon. And if you are a cancer survivor or a caregiver of someone who is, just reach out to our program director, Erica Narducci, and she'll help you come to class live like our friend Sherman is. You're all eligible to be here. Or just stream. It's safe. It's always safe. It's fun. It's easy. Take good care.